And welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Russ Courtnall Be a Pro series here in NHL 16 on the Xbox One. Now, here we are, seems like in purgatory right now, with Phoenix's AHL affiliate, the Springfield Falcons, trying to get back up to that main NHL roster with the Coyotes, but you know what? They called him up one game, he got concussed. Even though he seemed to be ready to go the next game, they sent him back down. I don't know. It's been a battle. A lot of you say it's a glitch, but you know what? The frustration is boiling over for Russ Courtnall. Usually not a fighter. We see him pick his spots. Right now, he's just feisty. He's ready to go in this game. Got a chip on his shoulder because the Coyotes just keep overlooking him time after time, even though he was leading the club in scoring at the time they sent him down. Come on, NHL, fix your game. This has got to be a glitch, right? I can understand making him work to get there in the first place, start him off in the AHL, but if you come up and you're tearing it up in the first, I don't know, dozen games or so, and then you say, nope, you're going back down. Crazy. Anyway, taking out his frustrations right there, as I guess so am I, at the fact that we're not playing in the NHL right now. Courtnall does lose this fight. You probably shouldn't have picked it in the first place. And it looks like he's got a shiner to show for it. Wonderful. All right, well, let's see how the rest of the game goes here. As we're already down 1-0 in the first period, Courtnall unleashes a shot that misses the net entirely. Wide and high, glove side. All right, he's coming down with John Scott. Scott gives him the pass across the crease. Nope, didn't get that shot off in time to beat the goalie. He makes a save and covers up. Still 1-0 as we are more than halfway through the game. Trying to get a shot off right there and another save, this time off of Courtnall's shot, as he is up to the task again, keeping Springfield shut out to this point. All right, just a couple minutes left in the second period. That pass is picked off, and now we're going the other way. Nice job defending the crease. Courtnall trying to get into the play here as they're going to pass us around the zone, and the shot eventually from the point is going to be tipped in, deflected. In front, and it is Courtnall getting his stick blade on that, redirecting the shot, and it ends up in the net. He's tied this thing at one apiece before we go to the second intermission. Nice job right there. John Scott getting on the score sheet as well with a helper. Take another look or two at this goal as, yeah, he was able to get enough of this to change its course and get it on in past the goaltender. So we are tied 1-1. Courtnall feeling good, at least that he scored a goal, but he's like, okay, you see what I'm doing down here, right? Call me back up. This is a chance in front, another shot. Pushed aside by the goaltender. Rebounds galore there, but he does finally cover up with under 2 minutes to play in the period. Some pushing and shoving, as we see often after the whistle. Courtnall looking for another one, but he was thwarted here. Whoa, did you see the stick break there on the initial shot? Blew up right in his hands, and a nice kick save on Courtnall's shot as you see it from in close on the goaltender. All right, 5 minutes left in this game. Courtnall is going to stop, redirection, and he gets this off to a teammate. Pass back in front to Courtnall, kind of a weak backhander there, and trying to set up a teammate, just not happening. Maybe he should be more assertive and shoot the puck, but after all, he is a playmaker, and he's trying to play to his strengths here and his style that they're expecting of him. Here in overtime, they're going to get him on a tripping call. Seemed kind of minor, especially for a call in overtime, but nonetheless, he'll be going to the box. Right there, yeah, okay, he sent him to his knees, and he lost possession of the puck. So we get through the overtime, and now we go to the shootout, and we go all the way to round 9 when eventually the puck ends up in the net. It's been a while, obviously, to get to the 9th round and be tied 1-1. A lot of misses there, but that one ends up in the net. Now we need to answer or the game is over. And, well, we're not going to do it. There's the stop, and the shootout is over. We drop this one to Binghamton. Just couldn't get enough offense going tonight. But what are you going to do? Can't win them all. So we drop this game 2-1 officially. And we'll have to regroup for the next one. Courtnall gets some good news. Don't know why he's playing on the third line to begin with, but they're moving him up to the second forward line, even though I think he leads this team in scoring and maybe even the AHL. He's right up there in scoring anyway. But yeah, I guess now he's just now worthy of being a second liner. I don't know. whatever. I know they want you to meet your goals in all the categories, and defense is sometimes an issue, as it is right here, giving up the first goal to Portland. But even despite that, I think they're a little harsh on how they move you up and down lines. Again, unless that is a glitch as well. Here is an opportunity for Springfield in the zone. Oh, I think that puck was actually knocked off the defender's stick by a forechecking Russ Courtnall, and it ends up in the net. Domi's going to get the goal unassisted, but I do think it is Courtnall that wrestles possession away here. Yeah, I think he kind of tipped that right to Domi off the stick of the Portland player. Anyway, whatever happened, it ended up in the net, and that's a good thing because we're tied at one halfway through the first period in our defensive end. Nope, Courtnall picks that off, and we're going the other way. Does he have any help? Well, he's around the defenseman. Can he make a move? Now he goes to the backhand, but he's thwarted by the goalie. What you got to know about me is, I don't do dangles. I'm not very good. Some of you like to point it out as if I don't already know, but yeah, all right. Anyway, I'm having fun playing the game. That's what matters, right? Oh, look at that. Go back to the bench, and even though I was trying to not expend too much energy, I maybe should have stayed on the ice, because down they go and get the goal to go up 2-1. We were already shorthanded, and it might have not been the best time for the line change. We pay for it right there as Knight puts the puck in the net. Yeah, it's a numbers game right there. I think the guy getting on for me probably got on late. So now we're down 2-1. Courtnall passing to a teammate. Like I said, really would like to be a playmaker here and set people up. Early on in the season, we were getting lots of assists, it felt like. And it's kind of dried up lately. I don't know, for whatever reason. We are swarming the net here, though. Plenty of chances. Still keeping it in. Oh, finally they get it out. All right, so it's a 2-1 game. Oh, we tie it up at 2-2 while Courtnall's on the bench. First period almost over. Shinneman bringing the puck up with Courtnall there, 2-on-2. Courtnall with the shot. It was quite a good wrister right there, but an even better glove save by the goaltender, keeping it on out of here and protecting this 2-2 score right before intermission. You see stretching out and flashing the leather to go ahead and make the save. All right, we've got the power play now. Let's see what we can do with it. Second period just opening up. That is another tip in front. Redirection by Courtnall, but this one the goaltender is able to get a piece of and make the save. Let's watch it again. Once again, camped in front. Try to like to get those deflection goals since, you know, my deking and dangling is almost non-existent. Got to try to find other ways to score. Hard-working goals, get in front, get tips, all that stuff. But what he really wants to do is he stopped right there on a nice save is be that assist guy, be that playmaker that he is supposed to be, set up his teammates, and right there is a prime opportunity in traffic, but he threaded the needle. Shot gets on the net, but Britton makes the save again. It's Shinneman who is stopped, but watch Courtnall in the corner. Yeah, set him up right in front, and nope, goaltender is there to stop it. So, nope, we tie it up again, 3-3 this time around, again with Courtnall on the bench. So with 5:38 to play in the period, oh, well, there we go again. Giving one right back. Was it Knight again? And I missed who got it right there, but it is now 4-3 Portland as there's under 4 minutes to play in the second period. Courtnall coming on in there and will get a shot on goal, but the goaltender once again sharp enough to make the save. All right, third period action. There's a save on our end and trying to clear. Coming on up, is that Domi getting the puck to Courtnall, and he's free, and he's tripped up to his knees, can't get a shot off. What is the call? It is penalty shot. Oh, that's great, that's wonderful, but once again, yeah, I'm probably not the best person to have this. I'm gonna have to hope he'll fall for the old backhand forehand or forehand backhand, because I only got really one or two moves and they're not good. So let's see if he has any chance of scoring here. Coming right in, up, going to pull it to the forehand, and he's just waiting for it. Could not get him moving side to side. Courtnall is thwarted on his big penalty shot attempt. We're still down 4-3, about half the period and more to play. Courtnall again looking for a pass. Oh, he just tips that onto the stick of Shinneman, and he puts it in the net. We are tied 4-4. I don't think Courtnall meant for that to be a pass, but he's going to end up getting an assist on the play. I think Courtnall was probably trying to get his own backhand shot off, but when he couldn't corral it, he was lucky it went right to his teammate, who is on the forehand to put it home. Nice play right there as we were able to get the equalizer. Okay, under 5 minutes to play. Can we get the lead now? Coming on up ice. Courtnall looking for his spot, and he steps in and wrists it to the glove side. Goal. That's the one that's going to put him up 5-4, and it could be the game winner. Courtnall finally able to find his spot and beat the goaltender. This time Domi setting him up. It's kind of been back and forth between the two. And this time Courtnall benefits from the setup and puts it home. Now, can we hold on to the game here with the 5-4 score? Well, the answer is, let's go to the sim. Yes, time is up. There's the final horn, and Springfield wins it 5-4. So it was definitely a high-scoring event, and we're able to win the thing in the end. So one of the very rare times that I actually meet all my goals in all categories, so I'll definitely take that. But you know what else, Russ Courtnall, I'll take? A call from Arizona. Bring him back up, please. We'll see you next time.
Thanks for watching videos here on SGU. Go ahead and subscribe on YouTube at Sports Gaming Universe. Follow me on Twitter at NotusFan for all the latest info. And go ahead and check out that official Facebook page as well. Looking for SGU merchandise? SportsGamingUniverse.Spreadshirt.com is the place. All summer long, I'm partnering with FanDuel to bring you some fun daily fantasy sports action. Go to FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse. And use the promo code SGU to get a free entry into a 50-50 league. That's FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse.